NG East stands for Next Generation at Innovation. Now, NG East is a multi-year, multidisciplinary project to characterize seismic ground motions for everything east of the Rockies. Ground motion characterization is usually an empirical process where we look at a lot of recordings and we use our knowledge of the physical processes and regressions to come up with those models. Those models are effectively just complex equations. Modelers are going to model the fault, the rupture of the fault, the wave propagation to different sites, trying to predict the ground motion. And that's really what is cutting edge with the project. And there's a lot of challenges with that. Like, how do you specify the parameters that you input in your model to come up with events we've never really observed? We do have a good understanding of earthquakes, their generation themselves, and ground motions for the West Coast, like in California, for example. In the east, the problem we have, we don't have that much data. And most of the recordings are for smaller magnitude earthquakes, which do not tend to cause a lot of damage. So that's a big issue for us. But we know, though, that in the east it's possible to have large earthquakes. And in fact, the largest ever documented earthquakes occur in the New Madrid fault zone between 1811 and 1812. There was three major earthquakes near magnitude 8. And we know that these could happen again. Right now we have about 60 core researchers and also people are involved in the management of the project, and there's additional graduate students and about maybe another 30 people contribute in different ways. We have geophysicists, seismologists, people in geotechnical earthquake engineering, and people are specialized in general in ground motion, so applied seismologists. And all those people work together and try to make this product something tangible, and we all have all our different areas of expertise. NG East is funded by a few major agencies. First and foremost, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, USNRC, that's supplying a lot of the funding, the Department of Energy as well, and EPRI, the Electrical Power Research Institute, is also contributing monetarily to the project. And then the USGS is a major partner, and they do supply a lot of the technical resources with their specialists. The results from NG East will eventually be incorporated in the updating of the USGS National Seismic Hazard Maps. And these are then adopted by the building code as a basis for design. Unfortunately, because of the timing of the project, we won't be able to make it in the next round of the map, but hopefully the main products from this work will be included in the subsequent release.